it's also completely out of context because it's like supposed to be events that wrap up the story of the world. Some people in the gym have read. For the style was the cartoons from the game Hyper Light Drifter, which looked really nice. But if you look, I thought I'd probably not have that much time to do this because I had to test and stuff, so I mainly worked on it in class only. And I like the style of this because the colors are really pretty, but each individual like shade or hue only has a few color bands. It's just like one shade, the darker shade. So I kind of took inspiration from that. And, I usually don't work at like high resolution. So that was really moving. This is my goofy storyboard. I am notoriously like not good at drawing humans, so this is my first like really trying to draw people in perspective, and my knowledge of anatomy is like completely nothing. But I want to push myself outside of my comfort zone and see if I can make something that looks passable. Here's the color blocking. I shrank down on the storyboards and then I put them in my pixel art program and traced over them with colors. And since it's like a bunch of bald mannequin people in the shot, so that's cool. Oh yeah, and then I guess there's a shot where the guy's drawing a blueprint of his dead sister. That's the story. His dead sister died in the morning. He's drawing a blueprint of the statue that gets revealed in that one, but I just didn't draw that because I didn't have the time. Here's a pixel art program. It's called Ace Sprite or something like that. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. But as you can see, there's a bunch of layers vertically here, and then going forwards, all the little cells are different frames. So I just drew. My layer management isn't really bad. I don't know what's really going on here, but I drew the thing. I used the lasso tool and selected. To like make little subtle movements for like easing or whatever, I just drew lasses over like parts of the drawing. I had like arms on every layer, sorta. And then you can kind of rotate them around, but it deforms the pixels really badly, so you have to go back and clean it up. For this specific shot, I decided to make the sky really pretty, so I just picked a bunch of random colors. I'll use this spray paint tool, and I just dragged all over the screen and put a bunch of dots on the screen. I don't know why I went with this in particular. I made this slideshow really late at night. I need to get to 10 slides. Can you hit the next button and see if it appears? So one thing I noticed about the hyper like pickup scenes is that they kind of had fun color overlay, sort of. Kind of stuff like gradients are really actual scenes. I don't really know if you can see the difference between these two pictures, but I went into Photoshop after I animated all of them, and I got like a soft brush and I drew a bunch of random colors all over the screen. I put it at low opacity, and I feel like that made it a bit more vibrant here, like as if there's I don't really know, smoke or steam, something all over the picture.
importing the thing into Unity. That's what we're using for the game. And I just exported a big sprite sheet with all the frames, and I sliced it into different frames to use in Unity. And then you can select them and make them into like animation clips, which you can drag onto a timeline that looks kind of like After Effects. So on the next slide, you'll see this is the Unity timeline, which I hate because it's like After Effects basically. And we put all these postcards in the scene. Like I just dragged the sprites and I rotated them around in like a 2D space. That crate there is like the camera tracking point. So I animated the crate like moving around and rotating to go to each point. And then right here in the timeline with different keyframes. And then I like programmed it so that the camera follows that point. And I turned off the crate so you can see it. It's just like an invisible object that kind of acts as the camera now. That moves between each name. And then here's all the different animation clips that I dragged in that I made out of the frames that just play the animation and loop them for as long as it could be there. I think that's it. Thank you very much.
What I was going to say is, I think, first of all, the animation is beautiful. It really does look like something you'd see out of, like, an indie game. Kind of reminds me of, like, Celeste or something. And I just think it's incredible. I've never worked with pixel art before, but I honestly thought about trying it out. And just seeing this, like, you did a great job. It's, like, I definitely even without the context, I really can kind of sense all the emotion in this animation. I love it, so great job.
Thanks very much.
Pulling the cloth off, that was very smooth.
Thanks. I've never drawn cloth before in my life, so I was like, oh no. And that was like 2 days ago. And then I animated the cloth and I was like, it's way too heavy and it doesn't look good. At least it looks smooth.
So good
is
making me just
want to
try and do pixel art as well. So
it's
like, it's awesome.
Thanks very much.
Okay, the Kyle color palette strike again. Yeah. Like every single one, you have just such ability to like make such a cohesive like color palette for each scene. Like all the colors are so well together, and also having like the advantage of knowing the story behind like this. Like it was so nice. But anyway, just the way that you made it flow, and like I love how you use like the little sticky post-it things to like go through all like different things. I thought that was a very cool transition, like the way to show the capacity of like the time and like how to mark them. But I thought that was really cool. And it was so well done, so good job.
Thanks very much.
Hey guys,
I'm going to
be like a little more from Junior.
So I'm working on this game with my friend who I met in second grade. So I've only ever been around him in second grade, but we kept in contact online. He lives in Seattle now. Sometimes I live.
always awe in front of masterpieces to cry laughing with your tour group. Make memories. Look at your guide. Unforgettable travel experiences.